So right now on News Center 5 at 4:30, we're going to take a deeper dive into the breaking news that we've been following. Delis all across just Massachusetts, but in many areas are closing because of listeria concerns. So here to give us some insight is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Director of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. So Dr. T, it's always great,
great to see you.
We talked about this a little bit before, but let's expand because it continues to be there. The supermarkets are shutting down delis to do what they call a deep clean. So can you kill, and what does it take to kill listeria?
Of course you can kill listeria, but it is hardy. And one of the things about it that's interesting, listeria can survive at lower temperatures. So it can survive in our refrigerators, which is one of the ways we think we keep our food safe. So what you really have to do is high heat. Listeria doesn't like high heat, and so that's one of the ways you can kill it. It's one of the reasons why we always tell pregnant women and immunocompromised patients to avoid unpasteurized cheese.
Right.
That pasteurization is the heating process.
When you say high heat, I mean, like, for example, if you got pastrami in the deli heated up, and that would just take the, that would sizzle it up, right?
If you heat up any of these deli meats to 165 degrees Fahrenheit, that kills the listeria.
That would kill the listeria. Okay, question two, and many people have. Let's say you bought deli meat at one of the stores, not Boar's Head, but you bought deli meat. Is that safe? These are the signs, by the way, that have been out in deli departments around here today. And again, back to the question. You bought deli meat, it's not Boar's Head. Is that deli meat safe to eat?
Well, I think we have to have a yellow light there, right? Let's face it. I mean, Boar's Head just recalled 250,000 pounds of different deli meats, including liverwurst, ham, across the country. But this is an active investigation. Some of the 33 people that have been infected so far said that they ate turkey. We haven't heard about recalls. So it's possible that there's potentially another type of manufacturer or supplier that has infected a deli meat. And the other thing is, remember, there could be cross-contamination. So some of that equipment in the deli could be infected. So I think right now we want to be very careful.
And stores are very responsive to that very point of, yes, everything is in the same pool, so we have to be careful.
And just one thing, reminder that the CDC says pregnant women, compromised patients, elderly, should avoid fresh deli meat. And really, it needs to be heated.
Good point.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're sitting at home, you're hearing this, you're a little concerned. So if you did eat deli meat recently, what should you look for?
Right, so remember again, there's only been 33 cases, all right? So this is low numbers, but listeria symptoms that typically can occur within 2 days to a few weeks after eating, fevers, chills, headache, signs of meningitis, confusion, at the extreme end, seizures, things like that. And in pregnant women, you can have sort of flu-like illness. It can be a little bit milder, but it can be dangerous for the fetus. So again, it is a serious condition, but it's rare.
Dr. T, thank you. Thank you for answering questions and landing the plane and giving us info. Maria?